Hi everyone, my name is Melinda with IWD Agency, and today I'm going to show you how to manage your inventory in Magento. We also have other videos in our IWD database, so be sure to go and check those out too. So, managing inventory in Magento. First, you want to start off in your Magento dashboard after you log in. Then we're going to come all the way to the left-hand side and click on Stores. After you click on Stores, you're going to go right under Settings to the top left-hand corner, and then you're going to click on Configuration. Once you click on Configuration, it's going to take you to the next screen where we're going to collapse the General. So we'll click this arrow that points up, and we'll collapse General. We'll click on Catalog. And then we'll scroll down and we'll click on Inventory, so the third one down. And wait for that to load. So once that loads, I'm gonna collapse stock options. I can show you the different options. The two inventory management options that we're gonna focus on are stock options and product options. So the first one we're going to look at is stock options. So we're going to expand the very first one by clicking the downward arrow. And then you'll see the different options here for stock options. So in order to change any of the stock options, you want to come over to the right and then uncheck the check mark to where the options all show. So you can manage your stock when order is placed by clicking yes or no. The next one is set item status to be in stock when order is canceled. So you want to make sure that the item goes back into stock when someone cancels an order. You can display the out of stock product, so you can show it on your website or you can keep it hidden by clicking yes or no. And so only X left threshold. This option adds an expression to all of your products. So the system will give it a load when only X amount of products are left in stock. So this is a great tool to use if you want to put a sense of urgency on your products. So let's say once all products only have 5 left in stock, then your customers will have a sense of urgency to purchase that product immediately. The next one is display product availability in stock on storefronts. You can show how many products you have, or you can choose to not show. And then you can automatically synchronize inventory data according to the catalog changes. You can choose yes or no. So after you're done with that, you can collapse it, and we'll go to the next one and click the downward arrow that says product stock options. So once you click that, we're going to do the same thing. Uncheck the system values for the options that you'd like to change within your inventory. So for the first one, you can manage your stock, yes or no. We'll leave that as yes. And then back orders. So for this one, you can allow back orders for products that are out of stock if you'd like. Most stores probably don't do this because the options are there in order to help in order of how much stock you have. So we can leave that as no. And then how many maximum products can someone add to their cart? So we can leave that as at 10,000. And then you can put in an out of stock threshold, and then here you can put minimum quantity allowed in a shopping cart. So you can change this option for different groups. So let's say wholesalers, in order to get a wholesale price, you have to buy 1,000 products. And then you can say general, you know, the minimum quantity allowed in a shopping cart is 1. And then you can do that for different groups. And if you don't want any of those, you can just hit the little trash can button and delete it all. So on notify for quantity below, so you can get a notification if your inventory hits below a certain quantity. So we can put this at 10 for all products. And then enable quantity increments, you can put yes or no. And then automatically return credit memo item to stock, you can hit yes or no. Once you're done configuring, you want to come up to the top right and click the big orange button that says save configuration. Wait for that to finish saving. And sometimes it may take a little while depending on how many changes you made. And then to the top left in the yellow highlighted area, you'll see you save the configuration. There you have it. Now you know how to manage your inventory in Magento. If you found this video helpful, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions, please leave them down below.